What's going on, everyone? I'm back once again due to overwhelming demand with another cigar review video. Just kidding. Not due to overwhelming demand, just due to me having to do something for a video to put out today. So I'm doing another cigar review video. Today I am doing Diablo Gusto, or Gusto. It's by Punch. It's got this nice little Joker looking fella. Pretty cool packaging. I kind of like whenever they come in these tubes. Most of the time, you know, it just makes it look a little more attractive, you know, gives it a little bit of curb appeal. I've never tried this one before, so this is going to be all new to me. Let's go ahead and there's the band. Yeah. Smells yummy. Diablo, which, if my, is that Spanish for devil? I think. I know Diablo is devil, but is that Spanish? Which is ironic, because I'm accompanying this today with some Jack Daniel's Old Number 7 Tennessee Whiskey, which, according to Steve Earle's mama, it is the devil's right hand. So we've got the Diablo and the devil's right hand. Now, on the last cigar review video that I did with the Camacho Corojo Robusto, I forgot to get a taste before I lit it, so let me go ahead and do that now with the Diablo. Okay. Interesting. There's a sweetness to it. And also, like, a little bit of what I call pepper, like on the last one. I don't know what the hell it is. I'm just calling it pepper, but there's sweetness to it also. Since I got a punch, I think I'll go ahead and punch it instead of using my squeaky, dull V-cut. I got this lighter. Zyko, I don't know. This is my favorite lighter. It's got a punch built in on the end, a decent punch, but the thing never works. I've had it forever. I don't know, it's got to be cleaned out or something, I don't know, but I'll still use the punch. I punched it with that, and I'll use my Lotus lighter to light it, assuming this one's going to work. There we go. Okay. Right off the bat, this has a richness to, like, a deep, rich flavor to it. Again, I'm no good at describing this stuff. I was reminded by a couple people, my brother included, in the last one when I was trying to think of what those giant, crusty nutshell things they use the nutcrackers for. Walnuts, that was the one I couldn't think of in the last one when trying to describe the Camacho Corojo. This one's not, it's not nutty, but there's like a bold, almost like a dark coffee. I don't taste that sweetness that I tasted initially at all. Nice draw. There's definitely a very pleasant, bold richness to it. The only way I can think to describe it is like a dark roast coffee. Okay, I'm not sure how well the Jack Daniels complements this cigar. Like, I think if I had a Guinness with this, it would be awesome. It's not horrible. I mean, actually, it's good. I'm just like thinking that if I had Hello? Oh, she's mad. What is it? She's a good watchdog. Watch this. Who is it? Who is it? Go see. There's a car stopped out in front of the house. She likes to let me know when there's people around, which I very much appreciate. So, as I was saying, it's not awful with the Jack Daniels. It's good, but yeah, like a dark stout would probably be really good with this. I must say, I'm quite enjoying this thus far. There is like a, is it like a, to people that don't like cigars, well, you're probably not watching this anyways, but you probably won't understand what I'm about to say, but it reminds me of like hay and horses. Not horse poop, just like, I don't know, that's what the smell reminds me of. Like, I guess that's when people say it's very earthy. I guess that's what it is. It almost reminds me, now remember, I'm no expert on this stuff, so like I don't get into the weeds about like wrappers and regions and short filler, long filler, all that stuff. I just try cigars and take note of the ones I like and the ones I don't like. Hello, hey, what are you doing? And this reminds me of the Alec Bradley, American Sun Grown Blend. That's what I'm trying to say. This reminds me of that. That's one of my favorites. And this is, so far, quite delicious. I gotta say, it really isn't like a bad pairing. The Diablo and the Devil's Right Hand. The sweetness, somehow, I don't really know how, but the sweetness of the whiskey kind of blends nicely with this. You know what this would be good with too? Is with a coffee, with a black coffee. The strong black coffee. I'm gonna make note of that. Burning nice and even. See that? Been going, I don't know, 15, 20 minutes or so. I don't know. I'm gonna ash it now. Nope, I guess I'm not. It's not ready. But yeah, nice even burn. This is really good. And you know, something I've noticed, I don't know how to describe this. I don't know how to describe a lot of things when it comes to this stuff. So I'm the world's worst cigar reviewer. Maybe that's what I'll title this when I review cigars. I'll start naming these videos World's Worst Cigar Reviewer Reviews Diablo by Punch. Diablo Gusto by Punch. Anyways, it's got a very, like, the only way I can think to say it is classic cigar smell. So, like, it smells like you, I would imagine if a stranger walked in here, they go, oh, it smells like a cigar in here, but not like terrible, you know what I mean? Like sometimes it might just smell like smoke and ash or whatever. To me, this is just a very pleasant, classic cigar scent. All right, so I just let this sit for about 5 minutes and it's still lit, which I like. It's really smoothed out. I mean, it's been smooth from the beginning. There's no harshness to this. It's starting to pick up a little bit more of those peppery notes, but nothing really overwhelming. The draw might be getting a little harder, a tiny, tiny bit harder. All right, so I'm like, maybe not quite halfway. And I just ashed for the second time. So, I mean, this thing's still burning nice. I'm gonna go ahead and take the band off. Oh, yeah, see, it's just going to slide off, which is nice. Still very pleasant. No harshness. I like this Diablo Gusto. This size is perfect for me, too. Like, the ring size, whatever it is, it's... I think this is probably considered a Robusto. I don't know. But yeah, it's not like a jawbreaker. And it's not too long. I really like the fact that I can set this down for a couple minutes, leave it unattended, and that it when I and then I pick it up and it's still lit. That would be particularly nice, you know, if I'm out with some buddies or I have some friends over or whatever, just set it down while we're having conversation and then go back to it and not have to relight it. Keep that nice burn going. It makes for a pleasant experience. All right, so I'm getting down towards the end of this. My final thoughts on the Diablo Gusto by Punch. This thing has been very pleasant. I haven't once had to relight it. I've set it down a couple times, come back to it. It's still going. Nice even burn all the way through. Haven't had to touch it up at all. I've ashed 3 times up to this point. Nice flavor, smooth. Like I said at the beginning, it's got like a bold richness to it. It's just now, at this point, starting to get like a little bit harsh. This is usually about how far I go anyways. Like I said before, I don't smoke them right down to a little nub. I would definitely 100% recommend this, and I would definitely get it again. I will get it again. You know, the last one I did with the Camacho Corojo Robusto, even though I like the Camacho Corojo Robusto, I like this Diablo Gusto a whole lot more. So I said in the last one I would get the Camacho Corojo Robusto again, but I like this Diablo Gusto so much more that I would get this over the Camacho Corojo Robusto. So there's a possibility that I might not get the Camacho Corojo Robusto again, because the place I go to has the Diablo Gusto and the Camacho Corojo Robusto available. So I would buy this one over that one. I like it significantly more. Just the fact that I didn't have to relight this is a huge plus for me. The one thing I would say, if I had to make some sort of complaint about it, is the draw did get significantly harder as it burned down. The draw is a little bit harder than at the beginning, and it got like progressively harder as it went. But man, flavor profile was enjoyable. The as I've said many times so far, not having to relight it has been nice even burn. It's only ashed three times up to this point. I like this. There it is. Diablo Gusto by Punch. Gets my vote. I'll get it again. so that's where I'm going to end this. I'm not going to go too much further on this. Thank you all for watching. Hope you enjoyed this. Hope you found my nonsensical information useful in some way. So yeah, thank you for watching. I'll see you in the next one. Bye-bye, everybody.
Bonus video. The Diablo Gusto, the Devil's Right Hand, and the Full Moon. Coincidence? I think not.